Yeah, Liam's home and it's amazing. Hey, you got a minute? I want to update you on the Victor Lord murder case.
Got a picture of Thomas Delgado on that file. Understand his friend Kalmar pointed the finger at him. You buying that? Or do you still think that Todd Manning killed his brother?
Yeah, we brought our boy Kalmar in when he refused to answer phone calls.
Well, you know, a lot of people don't like to talk to the police.
Yeah, funny, isn't it? He's shady, but he knows better.
Well, I understand that the Kalmar was pretty convincing.
Yeah. I don't know, Bo, it all just seems a little too convenient.
What else did Kalmar say?
Well, he just came out and said it. Delgado shot Victor.
He was there?
No, but that's why he says that Delgado took the gun from Todd so he could then shoot Victor and then frame Todd for it.
But why would a pro like Kalmar volunteer information? Now, do you have something on him?
No, and he made himself an accessory.
He's got an agenda. He wants you to believe that Tomas is guilty.
So he don't believe someone else is guilty.
Manning.
The prime suspect.
Do you think Manning's got something on Kalmar?
This is why we need you back on the job.
Does Kalmar have a family?
Never married, no children, parents dead. Coffee?
Yeah, please.
Yeah. Probably been here since you left.
It's okay. Siblings?
Yeah. Nah, none that we know of.
So he just has Thomas Delgado, his protege.
Yeah. I mean, you'd think he'd do anything to protect him.
Cream? Yeah, and yeah, of course he would.
He accused him of murder.
But why?
Lesser of two evils?
If Manning threatened Delgado's life.
Kalmar plus ball points the finger at Tomas.
If we're right, and Manning has Delgado stashed somewhere, my bet is he is keeping him alive.
It's leverage. Makes sense. Explains why Frenchie's sticking to his story.
Johnny, I gotta talk to you. It's a matter of love and death.
Hi, Roxy. We're kind of in the middle of something important.
More important than your future? More important than your happiness? More important than you need to know? And believe me, Johnny,
Roxy!
You need to know. John? Uncle Bo? Sorry. Hi. Roxy, a minute? Natty, what are you doing?
You breathe one more word, and I swear you'll never see your grandson again.
You can't do that.
Watch me.
You know, like I was saying before, I have some news that just can't wait. They're canceling my favorite show, Fraternity Row, and I am truly devastated about that, but I'm leading the protest, so I need you guys to go online and sign the petition.
Yeah, I don't really watch a lot of television, Ross.
Yeah, well, maybe you should, because maybe you could learn a lot about love, a lot. And, Bo, you used to produce the show, so maybe do you think that there's someone you could talk to from the network?
Well, Roxy, I'm sorry. You know, those days they're kind of over.
Yeah, you know, I tried to get your brother on board, but he blew me off, too. But I ain't going down without a fight. So where there's a will, there's a way.
Good luck with that.
You're gonna need a lot more than me.
No idea what that means.
You know, with Liam coming home, I was kind of hoping that maybe you and Natalie could work things out. Maybe get back together again.
Me too, Bo. Me too.
Yeah.
So we got Liam back. Well, Natalie made it pretty clear that one thing doesn't lead to another.
Did you tell her how you felt?
Yeah. I tried, Bowen. She said she didn't want to discuss her relationship, that she wanted to leave well enough alone. She's not interested, Bo.
You heard from the mayor?
Not lately.
This is insane. We need you back on the job.
John, you can always talk to me. You know, I don't have to be on the payroll.
It's not good enough for me, Bo.
Look, I want to see Victor Jr.'s killer brought to justice just as much as you do. What's your next move?
Well, we got nothing on Delgado, so I think we focus on Manny.
Okay, anything you need, let me know.
I need a beer. Can we grab one soon?
You bet.
Hey, my best to Matthew.
Thanks.
Okay.